Am I audible?
Yes, you are. Good morning, everyone. Thanks for joining on a holiday.
We don't have holiday, right, Yati?
EGOV doesn't have holiday, but Bell team has holiday. Any more people to join? We have 10 people. Bell Engineering, everybody has joined?
Wait, let me check.
I think I'll
get some more.
So, Elza, this session and the second session are the same people, right?
Yeah,
because we won't require actually 1.5 hours, so we can start with local setups on this session.
Okay, let's see. Depending on the Q&A. They're very thorough. So workflow today, you just need to show the workflow service and how we have configured for TL, because they are also going to pick up TL.
Okay.
So I just kept 1.5 hours because like online, I was not sure like what glitches we will face, but things are going smooth, Aniket. So probably, as you said, we can cover afternoon session also.
Yeah, we can just
local setup. Yeah. I think.
Hi, I'm facing some disturbance in the audio. Is it just me or everybody's facing the same?
It's fine with me.
When he started speaking, I'm facing glitches actually.
Yeah, same here. Glitches exactly.
You mean disconnect and try again?
Yeah, I just did that, but it didn't help.
Yeah, actually, your voice is breaking. Others are pretty clear.
I'll try once again.
Guys, just one request. All those who are not speaking, please go on mute. Thank you.
We are waiting for one more person to join.
Okay. So I'll just start some basic stuff. So good morning, folks. Today and tomorrow, so last week, I believe a lot of you were part of the sessions which happened on DevOps setup and digit deployment. So this week, as per the life cycle, we've scheduled sessions mainly on digit extension customization. So how do you modify services, how do you debug, and how do you identify, edit and update PDFs and stuff like that. So this is the first session in this bracket, which focuses on the workflows. So who all are there from BL side, Shashikalaji? Just a brief intro. So I mean, which all teams are there?
Myself, Shashikala, Vipin Vijay, along with Rajini, Ragini, Divya, Minju, Vidya Bhushan. All our engineering team, that is.
Engineering team. Okay.
Yeah, engineering team. And Pradeep is also there from DevOps.
Pradeep is also there. Okay. So any update on the DevOps setup till now? Has the Azure or AWS boxes been set up? Were you able to experiment all that we discussed last week?
Pradeep, you can brief Pradeep.
Yeah. So some kind of setup has been made on Azure. Kind of that I have to kind of understand the microservice based, you know, defaults that can be assigned to each microservice, because some values randomly, I think some microservices are failing because of some values, I guess.
Okay.
So that is what I have encountered. Let me check up with.
But at least you've been able to pull the code and deploy it on infra, right?
Yeah. Whatever images had been released, right? There was a set of images that you had listed. So those were the images, exact images I have used.
Okay. ठीक है
Yeah, everybody is in. I think we can start. So we have Aniket, who will be like taking the session for workflow. He has been working on this workflow service for quite some time. So he is an expert in this field. So Aniket, over to you.
Yeah, thank you. Are you guys able to see my screen? Hello?
Yes, we are.
Okay. So basically, workflow is a auditing and authorization, a sort of authorization service where like you can send any application like fire NOC, trade license or property tax, any application, and it authorizes and audits every step taken by employee. So for example, I will show you this sample config of TL. So if you see like the top level object, actually this is our configuration, the basic configuration for workflow. So this top level object we called as business service. So basically business service mentions all the states and whatever whatever roles that can take action on that states. So basically it sorts it's like our rules, what we define for a given workflow. So
Aniket, just 1 minute. Yeah. This is the configuration which we are going to define in the MDMS JSON files.
Put this one in DB because we have to run some validations on it.
Okay.
So there are CRUD, create update search API for this business service. I will show you the APIs once I explain you the variables in the config. Okay. So basically, what we capture here is tenant ID, the name of the business service, and the module which it belongs to. It's called business, and the business service SLA, which is the overall SLA for the application to get processed from the time it's initialized to the time it's approved or rejected, whatever the final time is. So we will keep subtracting from this value. So once it goes below zero, it will be shown as red in the UI. And so there is one, I will just open the code also. So there is this switch called egov.workflow.stateLevel. So currently I've set it to false. What this does is if it's false, then you will have to mention the work, you have to configure the workflow for each individual tenant IDs. Means for pv.amritsar, suppose for Punjab, for Amritsar there is separate, for Jalandhar there is separate. Then for every city you will have to configure a business service. If you have the same business service for all the tenants, then you can just set a state level tenant ID here, and you have to just turn this flag as true. So the same config will be picked up for all the tenants. Any questions so far on this field?
Nothing as such. So this basically all the services which you're saying, again it's defined in the contract and that is expected to be in the document folder, right?
Sorry, can you come back on the
see, what and all flow is it defined which mm-hmm. we have to customize? So is there any written documentation for that, or it's a part of contract only? We are not able to find it in core service, that contract folder is in where all the doc folder in that contract.
Okay. I will just find and share it with you. Means you need to know how to configure this business service, right?
Right. And yeah.
Yeah. I will just share that documentation with you. Okay. So basically what you have to do is there is this state object, right? So this corresponds to a specific state. And we just have one single API called transition. Means actually we have two APIs, one is search and another is transition. So transition performs the both create and update operations. So we have, for whenever we define a configuration, we have to start with a null state, because since we have same flow for both create and update, we have to define this null state as the initial state. So as you can see, first, this SLA is the state level SLA, let me just take this another state. Okay. So this is a state level SLA. Means how much time do you want to give for the application to stay in this state? So currently we don't take any action, but again this UI will show the value as red whenever someone crosses the SLA for a given state. It's not a mandatory field, state level SLA. This is the name of the state. So this is the initiated state. And there is another field called application status. So application status is basically the status of your application, which is saved in the business service. So for a, it's like a one-to-many mapping. So one state in your business service can map to multiple states in your workflow. Suppose you want to show applied as the application status while workflow goes through three or four processes in the meanwhile. So it's basically a parent level status, you might say, whichever you store in your business service. Then another field is doc upload required. So basically this validates whether you are sending any documents or not when you are trying to go ahead from this state. Then these two fields just define whether this is a start state or end state. And then we have this action array. So basically it tells that you can take a apply action on this initiated state, which will move it to a applied state, and the roles which can take this action. So basically now citizen and TLCMP is TL counter employee. These two roles can perform this action. So workflow will validate whenever someone calls transition API with this apply action, it will validate that the user has these roles. And if they have this role, then only it will forward that application to the next state. Otherwise, it will throw an error. So,
any doubt? So, there are two actions in that means.
So, initiated, basically, we need to give update also in initiated. So, the requirement was like when you are in initiated state, you can still update the same data, and you don't need to forward to the next state. That's why if you see, it's like a cyclic cyclic thing where you just call initiate again on this initiated state and it will go back to initiated. You can actually get a clear view here. So when you go to applied state, either you can forward it for pending approval or you can reject it and it will go to rejected. So you can take multiple action on a given state.
Okay.
So I will just show you the API. So basically this is our create API. So whatever JSON I was showing you, the same JSON is here. You got the point, right? You just have to keep defining the state objects, and inside of state object, you have to define this action as action sub objects, which will have roles, and whatever next state you define here should be there in this state config. So I have already created this. So once you call the create API, this will create this business service and store it into DB. So basically it will just enrich it with UUIDs and link them using UUIDs rather than the names which we do here. So this is just to make it more user friendly, where you can directly write the next state. And when you call create, it will just link them with UUIDs. So we have create search and update operation on this business service object.
Actually, how it's getting mapped with a means microservice level mapping. I'm writing a text.
If you go to this API called transition, so basically, means you want to know how module is getting connected with workflow, right?
Right. Yeah. Or it's some fixed string only we are supposed to give, like apply or.
Yeah. So suppose you have some application, TL application, suppose. So inside of, I will just show you the code also. So this is our top level class. So if you see, we are calling here a call workflow function, which basically internally calls the transition API. So this is the body of the transition API. So here you have to define the module name, the tenant ID, the business service. Then this is the important field called the business ID. So this is basically the application number, means if someone is making an application in your business service, you will have to make its entry into workflow. So whatever the key you want to give will go in the business ID. So that application will be tracked using this business ID. And this actions will come from UI. Hello.
Sorry, didn't get this. We are not making anything specific to one particular application, right? It's a common for. Hello.
Yeah. Go on.
So, here we are mentioning. Can you show that? Business ID equal to something PBTL test 3, which is means it's a kind of flow name, or what is actually this?
Yeah, so this is the flow name, right? This is the workflow name through which you have to trigger for the given application. So can you elaborate on your use case, right? What exactly you are saying, means which use case won't be satisfied your concern?
No. I just wanted to know, like, when this application means, I have in your UI, you are having new application, you are filling the form, it's going to the apply. When we say the apply, it go to the next state. So that thing you are mapping through this. But as a service level, how the microservice or how the services are getting understanding that when he say apply, this is actually the service it has to hit.
Yeah, correct. So if you see at this class, what it does is it extracts all the information, whatever is required to create this object, the process instance object, which is an entry in workflow. So what basically TL services is done does is when you click on apply, so whatever data it gets from trade license, it will create this process instance object from it. So basically, trade licenses will always know what workflow it's going to follow. So that will come as a constant, which is this new TL. Okay, and tenant ID and business IDs and action, which is the data which you will get from the UI. So business ID is basically your application number, the ID of your form.
You previously you were explaining about how we are configuring that like process workflow. You are giving the example of that, or you are explaining the workflow is.
So basically, this is how we configure the rules, is the workflow. So once workflow is configured, after that your business service will have to hit the workflow API.
Okay.
Means this is just the part where we are configuring the workflow. Once it's done for integration with your business service, with TL service or whatever. So for every application created, TL service will have to call this transition API to create an entry in workflow.
So this business ID would have been generated in your last step, means which we created.
Yeah. Your main business service. Oh. So trade license will generate the application number in its enrichment service. So what will happen is UI will send request to trade license. Trade license will enrich it with application number and everything, and then it will create this object internally, and it will call the workflow API. So once it calls this workflow transition API, it will refer to this business service which we created, and then it will either allow or reject that update call. Hello. Hello.
Yeah,
Vipin, is it clear?
Seriously, like half things are clear. Not getting it fully.
Okay.
Can you share with us some example, like UI level, how the things are happening?
Yeah, actually our Kafka server is down. Let me check one.
I think you are
not understanding what is the difference between the configuration which we are setting up and how the service is calling the workflow.
Yeah.
Actually, from UI, it would have been better, but there is some problem with our Kafka cluster, so I didn't go to the UI. Vipin, actually our Kafka clusters are down because of that. I'm not able to. But I will try to explain you through API. Otherwise, we can.
Okay. Can you again go back to the first service in which you created a flow?
Okay.
So we are having the initial state.
So this is the initial state, which will be null every time.
Right. And we are going to the next status is initiated. Actually, these are state text level moving. Initiate as such is again the new block in JSON only.
Yeah.
But
so,
where is this action mapping of this? Actually is.
So basically, what happened is when you are in this state, right? Initiated state. You can perform these two actions on this state.
So these are like predefined text. I can use only apply, or I can only use initiate. Something like that?
Oh, okay. So basically, what the overall work of workflow is to verify only these actions are taken, and whoever is taking this action have this role.
Okay. I was saying like these are like I can write rather than apply, I can say okay, something like that. I cannot write like that where.
Means
rather than action apply, if I say ABCD, it won't work, right?
See, you can define whatever name you want here. It won't matter. But this then, next state should be a feasible one. This is just name, right? It's just a key.
Okay. It's just a key.
Yeah.
Where is the action mapping of this key? Means this is like, a, okay, in the flow, if I say in developer sense, like I'm hitting ABC service, but right. I should know what is the ABC in the system. If I give XYZ and XYZ mapping is not defined, system will not understand.
Okay. So what happens is whenever in UI, UI will keep calling this process instance search API. Okay. So whenever it calls this search API, it will get this next action depending on the role of the user who has logged in. So suppose you have logged in as a TL counter employee. Then based on your roles, it will call this search API. It will return you all the process instances, means the entries from the workflow. So whenever you click on a particular entry, suppose you click on this particular entry, PBTL test 2. So it will give you this response. So in this response, you can see there are these next actions.
Okay.
So UI will just show you these two buttons, apply and initiate. It would have been actually more clearer if this would have
been. Yeah, means UI wise, I'm clear, like the button apply and cancel or rejected option will come.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
When I say apply, it will move to the next state also, which will be like approver will go for the document. Mm. Now, this is the like text wise mapping. I got it on apply. Actually, system has to perform something right along with the means. It has to send to the Kafka this message.
Yeah, making this kind of message. That is the work of this business service. So this transition API won't be called from the UI at all. Only your backend services will call it, the business service. So you will always call TL create or TL update, not the transition API, which does this thing. So basically you will always call this APIs.
Okay, got it now. Actually, yeah, this one service is only there, TL.create or TL.update.
Yeah.
And so based on flag, we are moving to next state.
Yeah. Okay. So you will always call create or update only from UI, and this will internally call this workflow API. Yeah.
Got it now.
Yeah. Actually, from you, I would have been able to explain better. Okay, so for some actions like pay, which are like critical ones, what we do is we rather than calling it from here, in synchronization, we call it asynchronous, like this in. Payment consumer. So if you see in trade license controller, whenever someone calls create or update, we just call the workflow in the same call, right? So if it fails or succeeds, depends on the workflow. But in case of pay action, what we do is we have written this consumers, trade license consumers, and this receipt consumer. So UI won't make any a TL update call. It will just create one receipt, and we will keep listening on that receipt topic. So whenever we get any receipt with TL as the business service, we will just update it. We will take the workflow action here instead of our normal TL or update call. Because what can happen is our receipt service means collection service might fail, and we would update here the status as paid, which is not the correct thing to do. So for payment related actions, we always do it in async manner once we get confirmation that the payment is done. So Vipin, actually it will be helpful if you can actually try to set it up locally so that you can see for yourself how it works.
Okay.
You can set up the TL and workflow, so it will clarify all your doubts actually.
JR side also setup is not fully microservice is not deployed, but or I mean just now Pradeep was telling me he needs something more detailed.
No, on your local IOC.
So what about remaining service?
Actually, that's scheduled from 2 to 4:30.
Okay. No, I mean to say, like, I will be deploying TL service and one more service, but other service it has to get from somewhere, right?
So you're saying pointing there. So basically, right. So what workflow requires is only user service. So fine. Anyway, actually, we'll have to postpone this thing because if that servers are down, it will be very difficult to set up everything.
Okay.
So what do we do, Aniket? Should we break now and then reconvene after some time?
Yeah, actually that will be better because this will become very difficult without UI to explain things.
Okay.
One second, let me quickly check with Nikesh once.
Yeah.
I will call Nitin.
Okay.
His call is busy actually. So another thing, I guess, so Vipin, you got the gist of this workflow, right? So you will configure one business service. Hello?
Yeah, Aniket, I got that means.
And this search also works based on your roles. So it will pick up the roles from the user info, and whatever actions that can be taken by these roles, only those process instance it will give in the response. Means suppose you are a TL counter employee, you have a role of TL counter employee, and if counter employee can take action only on applied status, then it will give you the applications which are in applied status only in the response.
Okay.
So Omkar, I guess we can just cover everything in the afternoon session only, from local setup to even when we run this locally, it will be more helpful, I guess.
Omkar has left the meeting actually, either disconnected or
Aniket, one request. Can you please summarize from the beginning once again?
Sure.
He's trying.
So Shrikant, basically this is our workflow configuration. So this tells like what all states you want and what all actions you want to be taken for the given states. Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
And this, what roles are allowed to take this action, and all that is there in this configuration. So what happens is whenever you are creating one new microservice, once you create a microservice, you will define this configuration for it, like how the flow of the application should work. Like first it should go to counter employee, then it should go to field inspector, and after that it should get approved. So for each step, you will create one state here in this configuration with appropriate roles which can take those actions. So once you create this business service, then all you have to do is just call create and update methods of your business service, that is your trade license, which will then internally call workflow service. So every time you call the create and update method, it will call this transition API, where it will send a key that is the application number of your trade license and the action which you want to perform. So based on the role of the user, it will either perform that action on that given state or it will reject that action.
Okay.
Okay. And the search is based on your role. So whatever states on which you can perform an action, only applications in those state will be shown to you. Okay. In your inbox. So okay. Yeah. So you are going to start with trade license only, right?
No, I am collect.
Hello.
We are going to start with M collect actually, the trade license.
Okay, so can you give brief idea about what is it so that I can help you with our workflow if anything?
M collect doesn't have as such any workflow. So yeah, obviously when workflow is required, it's required from the trade license only.
Okay.
M collect is like your universal collection or okay. miscellaneous collection.
Okay. You just need to call those receipt collection APIs.
Right.
Okay.
So that doesn't have as such any workflow, right?
No, those doesn't have workflow.
Okay. So and for your local setup, means when you say the local setup,
yeah.
So we will be pointing to we can point to your service or what?
Dev server, right?
Right.
Yeah, you can point. Actually, Elzan might be able to tell exactly which server you should point.
I
don't see any problem.
Can we point to, then Pi, can we connect to that server or Azure?
That server is also down actually.
Okay.
That's why I'm not able to go to the UI.
Because in local setup, you required us to point to some service, right? If we do
that,
you will be explaining it.
Yeah. So you will have to point to the user. Actually, you can run everything on your local, but then it's a tedious job to set up like 4 or 5 microservices.
Okay.
It's just, should I move?
No, that's
so. Aniket, I think we should discontinue for now, and then maybe in the second session we can extend a bit and cover this up. Is that fine?
Yeah, fine.
Any other state has any
nothing from. So Bell team, I think that is what we'll do. There seems to be some DevOps issue at our end. So what we'll do is we'll try to get that fixed, and then we already have another session from 2 to 4. So this session, what we'll do is we'll either try to cover there or then extend from 4 to 5 and then close this out.
Okay.
I've sent an email today to
Chalo. Thanks, guys. Thank you, Aniket.
And at the same time, when are they starting the citizen outreach part? Because on a phone call, she informed me that from this Wednesday, they'll be starting it off. But I'm just trying to confirm that on an email as well. On the platform upgrade, the designation and designation as well as department mismatch analysis have been done and shared with Elzan. The services of the latest build have been deployed, and Ramkin team.
He is dropped off now, Naveen. The infra is not working. So what we've decided is you guys also can drop off. We already have another session scheduled from 2 to 4:30. So what we'll do is we'll try to cover this as part of the same session, or extend the 4:30 session to 5 and then cover.
Sure, no problem. So which service he was accessing? I just wanted to know the name of the service so that I can just walk through the code.
He is dropped off. Let's cover that also, no? In the second session.
Okay.
So you guys can drop off. Thank you for joining.
Yeah.
Listed down some comments on the document which Ramki has given a feedback.